Hey Yoba, what's up? So we already got people here, that's cool. I think the rest of the people so far are just bots and such. Anyway, I just happened to notice they're doing a modded Rainmaker challenge right now. What are the rules? Oh yeah, that's the face cam. No. He's looking good, huh? She's the producer, I just gotta tell her one. Don't worry, we got Gilbert.
Hi, Gilbert.
He's down in the corner. Alright, let's see. I'm gonna start with this. Yeah, that's Gilbert the turkey. I don't know. I think. Was 2019 the first year we did Gilbert? Been featured in Thanksgiving streams before. Alright, so this is Rainmaker, but the Rainmaker's been modified, so it's like souped up now. It walks faster with it, it fires better three directions, I might add. So it's pretty fun to use. Oh, but you can only hold it for 30 seconds instead of 60. Whoever exploded. We're both gonna be seeing family, keeping it pretty simple. What about you? Going for it, going for it, going for it, going for it. No, thank you. Oh, you saw Gilbert.
Oh,
Yeah, this goes back to, she had the exact same Thanksgiving table decoration as a kid, and she had named it Gilbert. The original has long since gone. We just had that picture on Google. So, but yeah, that's where Gilbert came from. Super stuffed, guys. I mean, way more toward me than I probably should have. But it was really good, so. Honestly. Slice through the shield way easier. Lately, I've had a real chocolate problem. I've been telling Twitter about that. I'm pretty sure I'm pregnant. I've been eating chocolate lately, or just like something else. Oh yeah, with the KO. If someone tucked me into bed right now, I'd probably fall asleep. But I really want to play the modded Rainmaker. Plus, I can't go to bed this early. Like, mentally, I can't. I don't know, it's like something in my head that stops me from falling asleep this early. I don't know, my brain is weird, but we already knew that. Alright, I don't know, maybe I should just keep what I'm rocking right now? I don't know. Let me think. See, again, when I'm playing Rainmaker, I always use gear that has Object Shredder on it. Again, it helps you slice through the Rainmaker shield super easy. Wild Willy, thanks for coming by to say hi, though. Coming by to say hi, that's what I meant to say. Hope you have a good Thanksgiving. So with the Object Shredder, what pairs really well with it is either the high fire rate of this, and it has a good damage too. That does a lot of damage on vertical swings, and a Splatling does a lot of damage because it's a Splatling. High fire rate. So, what am I gonna go with? See, then I overthink, and then I stare at the equip screen. Probably don't want. You know what? Screw it. I'm gonna stick with what I had. We're going with it. Thanks, man.
random story.
Oh, random story time, random story time.
Okay, so earlier this evening, I went for a walk, and as I walked along, a bug flew into my eye.
Wow.
Yeah, and it was really uncomfortable and painful, and I'm wiping my eyes without, like, feeling bloody pieces.
Ew, gross.
Yeah, gross.
Gross,
right?
No.
Anyway, so I'm pretty sure I got most of it out.
So,
I seem okay. I get home. I lose my drop.
I'm surprised you're just telling me this now.
So, well, it's better, right? So I lose my drop, but I don't look in the mirror. So now, I just happened to look in the mirror. Glad I did. There was still a little piece of bug body left in my eyelash line, right next to my eyelash.
Wow. I'm sorry that happened to you. When did you notice it? You know, when did you say you noticed it? Oh, okay. No, sorry, I thought you meant like, I should have said, okay, never mind. Oh shoot, now it's a party. He even said hi to Gilbert. Oh yeah, basically a bug flew into her eye while she was on a walk. And I feel really bad because it's like grossing me out, so I can't imagine how much it's grossing. Was it like his butt?
I don't know, I didn't analyze it. I didn't know.
All I know is. Ew, it was bug guts. Ew. No squid bagging yet. That's really new. Squid bagging. I feel like I only get squid bagged like once every 2 weeks. Maybe even once a month. The look I just got. It was great. Try slasher. Jerk face the blue. Game audio's a bit too loud, I'm on it. How's that? Is that better? I can go way more down if it needs to. Like I said, if you need me to go lower on the volume, just let me know. Happy to do it. Yeah, see, I hate when that happens. That's why I don't mind you pointing it out, because I want to fix it if the volume is off. So yeah, that was a cool story. Still sorry that happened to you, though.
You know, I don't like eyes, so I was pretty good.
I would have been for you. Aw, man, I almost came in with the victory. She just went in the other room. That's our producer. Tweeter wife. Tweeter girl. Be right back.
Just a sec.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry I broke your phone screen. Oof, I'm sorry. But thank you for healing with us on this Thanksgiving Eve. I love having the Ultra Stamp and Rainmaker. You just clear a path. You're like towing someone along, basically. Tow someone else along to carry the Rainmaker. I sound sad, do I? Oh, it might be because I was trying to sneak in chewing. I was trying to sneak in some chewing because I have chocolate animal crackers. Sorry. Dude, you can get big bags of them on Amazon. It's amazing. Well, that's true. I am legit tired, too. I'm thinking about the sleeping in I could do tomorrow. Yeah, because you busted your ass. So I figured you were relaxing, healing your ass while you were watching the stream. Do not lay on the volume remote. Thank you. I didn't mean that kind of healing. Not like, the Lord help you. The Lord help you. Like, nah, not like that kind of healing. Really? She started singing a song in the other room. Dang it. I've been thinking about getting a gaming laptop for streaming purposes and just for general purpose use as well. But I would only do that when my current computer like completely dies, like when it's totally unusable. It's slow now. I mean, well, I shouldn't even say slow. It's not even that. It's just, it's 5 years old and it's shown its age. You know what I mean? For what it's worth, it shipped with Windows 10. Now it's got Windows 11. It's official Windows 11 because it's actually an 8th gen processor, so it's legit. Yeah, during Rainmaker, I'll just use the Ultra Stamp and just, I'll kind of hope that somebody follows me with the Rainmaker, since, you know, I got the Ultra Stamp. Sometimes they do. Nah, I got Microsoft OneDrive. I have literally all my storage either externally stored somewhere and or on Microsoft OneDrive, so... Nah, I'm good. I got stuff backed up. I used to be weirdly, like, against cloud storage, because I was always like, no, just use physical media. That way you have it. You don't have to rely on a server being online all the time. But if you get a reputable one, like, from Microsoft or Google or iCloud or something, you know... A legitimate one. You know, they have data redundancy. Your data is safe. But if you have just one copy of your thing saved on a flash drive somewhere, you know, you gotta have that stored in a cloud, because if the flash drive goes bad, then you lose that data, it's gone. And in the IT work I've done over the years, it's scary how you really don't see hard drive failures come, they just happen. And that happens, you only really have two options. You can either be prepared and follow your contingency plan, or panic. I mean, that's really your only option. Oh, hello from England. Like, having a copy of your stuff on one thing is good, yes. But you definitely don't want to stop there. You want to have a redundancy plan. Something, you know, where plan B, it's on a cloud as well, you know. You just never know. Yeah, Night Freak, that'll only literally get worse. Sometimes I feel like I worry about data loss, like some people worry about, like, the apocalypse or something, but, the only way to have a data backup plan is to have a backup plan, so if you don't have a plan in place and something bad happens, then it's just game over, that's it, you're done. Well, every time you bump it, it's unplugging because something is loose somewhere. Whether if it's external where you can see like a tear in the cable or something, or like maybe the cable's crooked, or it's internal with like the tin inside the wire where it's, you know, physically has a gap in the wire, like a cut or, you know, a slice that you can't see because it's internal. But every time you bump it, whatever it is made that much worse because it just moved technically. So it's gonna move more and more and, you know, get worse. Clear path. Which means I have to hit the checkpoint. Throw it. Yay. Not sure what happened to my teammate there, but. Situation where you really want to have object shredder. You want to be the one that's slicing through the shield of that Rainmaker. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. I love the modded Rainmaker. You move faster, you get the triple fire, it's so cool. I mean, Nitric, that's honestly not a bad idea. I didn't think of that, but, you know, sometimes the best ideas are the easiest. Oh. I'm sorry. If you're already getting a laptop, might as well get a new hard drive to go with it too. There's squid beacons everywhere. In the opponent's team, I want to fix that. and this other team is really aggressive. Oh, an SSD is miles ahead of the hard drive in terms of performance. I don't know, probably like a 10 times read and write speed increase, yeah. Spinning hard drives, it's in that weird transition period with technology where, like, we're halfway into spinning hard drives, spinning mechanical drives, and halfway into flash storage right now. It's very 50-50. Yeah, anything mechanical like a spinning hard drive or a spinning disk drive, like a Blu-ray disc, the read speed is going to be so much slower than just flash storage. A lot of times it's that peripheral alone that's actually the bottleneck in the entire system in terms of speed. Am I the only one trying in this fight? Where was the rest of the team? I really like the Mario Kart 8 DLC. I can't believe that we finally have all of it. Feels like forever since I announced it. Oh, speaking of Mario Kart, the other day I went to Best Buy because I did a ship-to-store thing, and they looked like they were ready for, like, a console launch, because they had the I forget if it's OLED or not, but they do this every year with the Switch. They do a holiday bundle where it's like, oh, it includes Mario Kart 8 for free on it. Like, you know, that's cool. I can't remember if it was OLED or not. Please tell me before it was coming out. But anywho, yeah, it looked like they were ready for console launch day because they had this table of them set up on it, and the table was like five consoles tall. It was like a whole box, like a cube setup of just consoles, probably like 100 of them. I don't know if Best Buy was doing like some doorbuster thing, and they were like, bro, we're so ready. Oh, Night's Free. That was a nice comeback. But man, how old was your phone that it was no longer compatible? What phone do you have? Also, I like calling it Marvin Kart. That's funny. What year did that phone come out? Like, I know you said when you got it, but do you know what year the phone was released? 6 a.m. stream? That's disgusting. I like your nicknames. Don't you just have bad luck with your internet, like, all the time? Trip to kill though. Yeah, I didn't think they actually gave you one. This. I also think it's cool that you met the guy that gets to go, "It is I, Mario the Plumber." That's pretty cool.
The cat just woke up and scared himself.
Oh, boy. It's like,
you know, when a cat wakes up and one thing startles them, and for some reason that startles the thing next to them there, and then that startles the thing next to that, and it's like a chain reaction, and then before you know it, they're totally scared. That's teamwork. That's some teamwork shit right there. Boom! Thank you. By the way, the cat's still on edge about the one thing it woke up from 3 minutes ago. I figure if it stays quiet, we'll go for another 10 minutes and call it a night. Give us a whole hour of Gilbert the Turkey. Oh well, I tried. Nightfreak, I think you remembered his name last year too. It's crazy. That's the question you'd get right at trivia night, that's for sure. We have a we officially have a Thanksgiving tradition, everybody. It's Gilbert and Night Streak remembering his name. Yeah, that was pretty crazy. I got away from our train maker thing. I can't believe there's still a market for Famiclones. Yep, guest starting the clock.
Super Mario 3 Mix. Yeah, that's gotta be my favorite Mario ROM hack ever.
Dang it, Bobby. Sorry, I just read your Mario Rack text there in the chat. That's awesome. Alright. Well, it was still cool hanging out with you, Night Street. It was basically you and me hanging out this past hour. Some others showed up for a few, but it's all good. It was Thanksgiving Eve. I figured some people might be busy doing other things, so. But the producer, aka Tweeter Girl, she insisted that we had Gilbert, so wanted to do Gilbert. Well, I hope you have a good holiday. To those who celebrate. And 69, nice. And yeah, I guess that's it. I'll get this archived on the channel. See you guys next time.